The country of Malawi, east of Zambia, has a remarkable scenic beauty with numerous mountain blocks covered by tropical forests and grasslands and scenic waterfalls. The climate is relatively cool, and the native population is concentrated in the lowland areas and around Shire, the major river flowing into the Zambezi. Lake Malawi, the third largest lake in Africa, lies in the Great Rift Valley. The characteristic savanna vegetation is dominant, but due to relatively poor and rocky soils, it is not comparable to other areas of tropical Africa. Remarkably, wildlife is rather absent, hence there is no major attraction for tourists. Coniferous trees appear at higher elevations, but the native species does not form productive forest tracts. The large majority of the people have to depend on marginal subsistence farming, aggravated by one of the highest population growth rates in tropical Africa, some 4% per year, as compared to 1.2% in the United States. The extensive high grasslands appear to be attractive for cattle raising, but are not used for that purpose by the native people. The tsetse fly, a major problem in the warm areas of the savanna, is not a problem, partly due to the absence of game, which are the major carriers of the deadly nagana in cattle and sleeping sickness in humans. European colonists generally bypassed Malawi, mainly because it lies considerably inland and access to the coast would be time-consuming and difficult, especially during the rainy season. For the same reason, Malawi did not experience large-scale slave raiding by the Arabs, as they concentrated on the areas around Lake Tanganyika. The grasslands could be used by Europeans for cattle raising, but there were large areas for that purpose along the main access road to the interior from Mombasa towards Uganda. Even the missionaries had little influence, handicapped by distance from the coast and sparse population. It is not clear at present time whether the grasslands are due to extensive deforestation at earlier times or some other factor. Agricultural activities were not the cause, as the climate is rather cool for native crops. The British colonial powers realized the potential of the highland areas for tree plantations, and extensive tracts were established since the 1930s. But the trees are not of high quality, and the native population built its huts by using local materials. With independence, the country did not acquire any degree of prosperity. There is hardly any industrial development, and no foreign investors are interested in any major projects. Remarkably, even the mining potential appears to be rather marginal, and Malawi remains one of the poorest countries in tropical Africa, with a per capita income of only $180 per year.